This is the image I was trying to replicate. I started out with a plane, but I subdivided it in such a way that all the geometry converges at the center. I added pins to the sides to help with the wrinkled effect I'm going for. There's also a bit of ridging or fanning effect that you can see in edit mode, where every other edge loop is raised or lowered alternately to help push the wrinkling effect before simulating. I'm using a multi-resolution modifier to add subdivisions to the cloth instead of a subsurface modifier, since I'm anticipating needing to do some sculpting after I've finished simulating. I then added the lamp in the middle and made it into a collision object so as to gather the cloth to generate a billowing effect. As you can see, after I've baked, I'm going in and making adjustments as needed to the geometry and adding or subtracting vertices from my vertex group that I'm using with the cloth modifier. Trying to make realistic cloth will sometimes take a few tries. You can see the vertices I'm using as my pins when I hit the select button in the vertex groups panel on the group vertex group. I'm making changes to which vertices I'm pinning based on the bake results. I noticed that pinning a few vertices here and there closer to the center of the cloth helped exaggerate the wrinkles a lot, which I liked. I added a solidify modifier to create thickness in the cloth. When I have my cloth looking how I want, I apply the cloth modifier. I then go into sculpt mode to take care of any clipping in the fabric or other objects. If this video was helpful to you, why not leave it a like and subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this one? This has been Ariana from TimeFire. Thanks for watching.